Hello and welcome to the e-learning session of the herpes viruses part 2. So this is the part 2 of the herpes viruses. So now you are familiar with this type of classification. According to this, there are three major subfamilies, that is alpha, beta and gamma. In the part 1, you have gone through the herpes simplex virus type 1 and herpes simplex virus type 2. So in this lecture we will go to the varicella zoster viruses, Epstein-Barr viruses and cytomegalovirus. The rest are also less important. Among this HHV8, that is herpes simplex herpes virus 8, that can cause the Kaposi's sarcoma. So let us move forward to the varicella zoster virus. Varicella zoster virus produces the vesicular eruption on the skin and the mucous membrane in the form of two clinical forms. One is chickenpox. In that, there is a diffuse bilateral vesicular rashes are there, which occurs following primary infection, which is usually seen in the children's. While the second form is a zoster or shingles, it occurs following reactivation of latent varicella zoster virus infection present in the trigeminal ganglia that occurs mainly in adult life. Vesicular rashes are unilateral and segmental, and they are mostly this infection is mostly seen in the adult life. Now the pathogenesis part. The pathogenesis of the chickenpox involves the following steps. One and important is a portal of entry. In that, this virus enters through the upper respiratory mucosa or the conjunctiva. And the second is spread. It replicates in the regional lymph nodes, that is, spills over and enters into the bloodstream, where it can cause the primary viremia. From this, it spreads to the liver and spleen and it multiplies. Again, it enters into the bloodstream, where it can cause the secondary viremia. This virus is present in the infected mononuclear cells that are transported to the skin. In the skin, viruses replicate in the epithelial cell that leads to development of typical rashes. Then it will transfer to the respiratory tract, where it shed in the respiratory secretions of the infected individual, that leading to the transmission of the infection to other individuals. From this, it will transported to the neurons, where VZV gains to access to neurons of trigeminal ganglia and undergoes the latency. So this is the pathogenesis part. Now the clinical manifestation. Incubation period is about 10 to 21 days, mostly a 2 to 3 weeks. Typical description of the chickenpox rashes is, first and important is the rashes that are vesicular, that you can see in the picture. Then centripetal in distribution, that usually starts on the face and trunk, and from this spread rapidly to the involar flexor surfaces, sparing the distal part of the limbs. Then bilateral and diffuse in distribution. Rashes appears in the multiple crops. The lesion is various stages of the evolution, such as maculopapules, vesicle, pustule and scabs, can be found in one area at the same time. Then the fever appears with each crop of rashes. Chickenpox is a disease of childhood. When it occurs into the adults, it is more severe with bullous and hemorrhagic rashes that leaving behind pitted scars on the skin after the recovery. So we have to differentiate it with the smallpox. In the smallpox, the fever is at 2 to 4 days before the rashes, while in the case of chickenpox, fever is at the time of rashes. The rashes appearance is poke at the same stage in the case of smallpox, while in the chickenpox, the pokes in the several stages. Development is slow in the case of smallpox, while the rapid development will be done into the chickenpox. You can see the picture, the rashes of the smallpox and the chickenpox. You can clearly differentiate this both. Mostly chickenpox is a lesser in severe disease. in the case of smallpox with a yes. Then the complication. Complications are more common in adults in the immunocompromised individual. Most common infectious complication is secondary bacterial infection of the skin. Most common extracutaneous complication is CNS involvement, where cerebral ataxia, encephalitis, and aseptic meningitis is usually seen. That is, occurs into the children. Most serious complication is varicella pneumonia, which develops more commonly in adults, up to 20% of the cases, than in children. And it is particularly severe in pregnant women. Then there are other complications like Reye syndrome that can occur secondary to this VZV infection. It is characterized by fatty degeneration of the liver following the aspirin intake. Then other complications are myocarditis, nephritis, corneal lesion, and arthritis. There is a neonatal varicella is also there. If mother develops the chickenpox more than 5 days before delivery, then baby is mostly asymptomatic due to protective maternal antibody, which prevents the transmission of the virus during delivery. If mother develops chickenpox 5 days before to 2 days after the delivery, then maternal antibodies would not have to produce in such short time. This leads to dissemination of the virus in the baby and causes the neonatal varicella, which is a severe form of chickenpox with mortality rate exceeding 30%. Then the zoster or shingles, or it is also called the zona. Zoster is usually occurs due to the reactivation of the latent varicella zoster virus in the mostly old age and also in a immunocompromised individual or occasionally in healthy adults also. It usually starts with a severe pain in the area of skin or mucosa supplied by one or more groups of sensory nerves and ganglia. Rashes are there. They are unilateral and segmental, which confines the area of skin supplied by the affected nerves. You can see in the picture. The most common nerve involved is the ophthalmic branch. You can see in the picture. Then it is most common nerve is ophthalmic branch of the trigeminal nerve. There is also a head, neck, and trunk is also most affected common sites. Then complication of the zoster. First is post herpetic neuralgia, where pain in the local site lasting for the months, and it is most common complication in elder patient. Then zoster ophthalmicus. That is, a patient comes with unilateral painful crops of the skin rashes surrounding the eyes. Then Ramsay-Hunt syndrome, which when patient develops when geniculate ganglion of facial nerve is involved. It is characterized by tetrads of facial nerve palsy plus vesicalon, tympanic membrane, external auditory meatus, and the tongue. Then vesicular disease, especially in pneumonia, can occur, which is the most common cause of death in zoster patient. And also recurrent or chronic zoster is common with HIV infected patient. Then lab diagnosis of this virus. Lab diagnosis is first there is a cytopathology where you can do the GIMSA stain or Zank smear that reveals the cytopathological changes similar to the HSV infection, such as formation of multinucleated giant cell. You can see in the picture. Then virus isolation is another option. Virus isolation in various cell lines can also produces HSV-like cytopathic effects, such as diffuse rounding and ballooning of infected cell. You can see here. There are other options like specific antigen detection by direct immunofluorescence staining, or you can also do the PCR for detecting varicella zoster virus specific genes. Vaccines is also available. The composition is a live virus with a OCA strain or Merck strain. Efficacy of this vaccine is mostly 95%, which ranges between 65 to 100%. ड्यूरेशन ऑफ इम्यूनिटी इज मोर देन 7 ईयर. द शेड्यूल इज इफ द पेशेंट इफ द इंडिविजुअल इज फ्रॉम 1 to 12 ईयर ऑफ एज देन 1 डोज इज रिक्वायर्ड. वाइल इफ द पेशेंट इज मोर देन 12 ईयर्स देन 2 डोज इज रिक्वायर्ड विथ 6 to 10 वीक्स अपार्ट. The route is subcutaneous and it may be administered simultaneously with MMR vaccine. And the second virus of this classification is cytomegalovirus, which is medically important. The name suggests cytomegalo. That means it is massive and it causes massive enlargement of the infected host cell. That's why this is called cytomegalovirus. This is the largest virus in this family. It is the agent of beta subfamily. Cytomegalovirus is viruses are strictly species specific. Like human CMV does not infect animals simultaneously. Similarly, a number of animal CMVs exist which does not infect humans. In cell type specificity, in vivo CMV infects kidney and salivary glands where it undergoes latency. In vitro, CMV replicates only in human fibroblast cell line and will produce characteristic cytopathic effect like owl's eye, which you can see in this picture. You can see there is a owl's eye appearance. CMV is almost always closely associated with the cells and spread cell to cell, so that it very little little virus may be cell-free. Then clinical manifestation. There is a 4 major clinical manifestation. The first is congenital, then perinatal, mononucleosis-like syndrome, which is seen into mostly immunocompetent adults. And the fourth one is immunocompromised host. So in this type of infection, In congenital CMV infection, most common this is the most common intrauterine infection which is associated with the congenital defects. Cytomegalic inclusion disease develops in about 5% of the infected fetus. The 5 to 25% of them may develop significant psychomotor, hearing, ocular or dental defects within 2 years. Congenital defects include most common defects is petechial hepatosplenomegaly and the jaundice. Less common defects include microcephaly, cerebral calcification, intrauterine growth retardation and prematurity. Occasionally defects inguinal hernia and the risk is maximum if the infection occurs in early pregnancy and if the mother is infected during the pregnancy. The risk is maximum. Mortality rate is very high, that is 20%. Then second is perinatal CMV infection. Transmission to the newborn occurs either during the delivery through the infected birth canal or postnatal through the infected breast milk or secretions from the mother. Most of the infected infants remain asymptomatic, but it shed virus in the urine from 8 to 12 weeks of age. Few infants, especially premature babies, develop interstitial pneumonitis. The third is immunocompetent adults, where mononucleosis-like syndromes are there. We have to differentiate with the infectious mononucleosis with this type of infection, where agent of the infectious mononucleosis is Epstein-Barr virus, which is the next variety of this family. Then in the mononucleosis-like syndrome, it can be caused by the CMV, cytomegalovirus. Atypical lymphocytosis is seen into the both. Then clinical symptoms. There is a fever, myalgia, hepatosplenomegaly, exudative pharyngitis, cervical lymphadenopathy and rashes in the case of infectious mononucleosis. While in the case of mononucleosis-like syndrome, there is a similar presentation, but There is an exception of exudative pharyngitis, cervical lymphadenopathy are absent in the case of mononucleosis-like syndrome. Then heterophile antibodies are elevated with the Paul Bunnell test in infectious mononucleosis, while it is negative in the case of CMV. Specific antibodies are specific to EBV antigens are elevated in infectious mononucleosis, while antibodies to CMV or other agents may be elevated in mononucleosis-like syndrome. Then immunocompromised host, where this CMV produces markedly severe infection in immunosuppressed individuals, most of which are due to reactivation of their own latent virus. In AIDS patient with CD4 T cell count less than 50 per microliter, CMV may cause the chorioretinitis, gastroenteritis, dementia, and other disseminated infection. Then patient with organ transplant, CMV is probably the most common viral infection that occurs in transplant recipient. Infection occurs usually between 1 and 4 months, where a patient develops bilateral interstitial pneumonia is the most common form, which is seen into the 15 to 20% of bone marrow transplant recipient. That is, a febrile leukopenia is seen among solid organ transplant recipient. The laboratory diagnosis. First is detection of the inclusion bodies. In urine, CMV produces the characteristic perinuclear cytoplasmic inclusions in addition to the usual intranuclear inclusions, which is seen into the herpes viruses. The inclusion bodies are of a owl's eye appearance, which is seen here. That is a characteristic picture of the CMV. Then second is virus isolation. CMV can be isolated from the throat, washing and urine and humor. Fibroblasts are the most ideal cell line that's specific for CMV. In the virus isolation cytopathic effect, you can see the typical CMV inclusions like owl's eye appearance. Then antibody detection, CMV IgM antibodies and CMV IgG antibodies. And also antigenic detection is also there, where here they are using CMV specific PP65 antigen, which is a major matrix phosphoprotein. You can also do the molecular methods like PCR to detect the specific CMV DNA in blood or body fluid, such as CSF. So this is all about the CMV. Now we will move forward to the Epstein-Barr virus. Epstein-Barr virus is a member of gamma subfamily of herpes viridae that causes infectious mononucleosis and variety of human tumors like nasopharyngeal carcinoma, Burkitt's lymphoma, Hodgkin disease, and B-cell lymphoma. Then the pathogenesis part. EBV is transmitted by the oropharyngeal contact through the infected salivary secretion. The first EBV binds to the specific receptor which is present into the B cell, that is CD21 or CR2, which are also receptor for C3B component of complement. Such receptors are also present on the pharyngeal epithelial cells. Then primary infection, which is occurs into the oropharynx. EBV replicates in the epithelial cells of surface B lymphocytes of pharynx and salivary glands. Following entry into the B cell, this virus directly enters into the latent phase without completing the viral replication. Though majority of the infected cells are eliminated, a small number of infected cells may persist for lifetime. Virus spreads from the oropharynx to the other sides of body and is capable of undergoing reactivation later. Viral shedding continues in oropharyngeal secretion at low level for weeks to months and serves as source of infection. In children, infections are subclinical, but young adults often develop a condition called acute infectious mononucleosis. Now the infectious mononucleosis. It is also called the kissing disease because it is transmitted through the salivary contact. Mostly young adults of developed countries are usually affected with this virus. The infectious mononucleosis is characterized by the headache, fever, malaise, pharyngitis, cervical lymphadenopathy, hepatosplenomegaly, rashes, which is following ampicillin therapy, atypical lymphocytosis. So the clinical manifestation is there. Now the EBV association. The first and important is Burkitt's lymphoma, which is a tumor of Cho seen in children and young adults. EBV is associated with 90% of African and 20% of non-African cases of Burkitt's lymphoma. Then second is nasopharyngeal carcinoma, which is seen among Chinese people who have history of intake of salted fish and herbal snuff. Then Hodgkin's disease, especially in mixed cellularity type. EBV DNA is found in Reed-Sternberg cell in the least 50% of cases of Hodgkin's lymphoma. And NHL or non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, all CNS non-Hodgkin's lymphomas and 50% of the systemic non-Hodgkin's lymphomas are EBV DNA or antibody positive. Then other condition which is associated with the EBV is lymphoproliferative disorder, which is seen among immunodeficient patient, and other is oral hairy leukoplakia. It is a wart-like growth of epithelial cells of the tongue, which is developed in some HIV-infected patient and transplant recipient. There is also a chronic fatigue syndrome is also there. Now the lab diagnosis. There is antibody detection, mostly a heterophile agglutination test, that is Paul Bunnell test. Which is a tube agglutination test that uses the sheep RBC to detect heterophile antibodies in patient serum. The agglutination titer of more than 256 is considered as a significant. False positive heterophile antibodies are non-specific, that may also be present following serum therapy or even some normal individual, hence confirmation is must. Then there is a EBV specific antibody test. The first is antibody to viral capsid antigen VCA, that is of IgM and IgG type. Then antibodies to early antigen, this also indicates current viral infection. They are elevated in patients with Burkitt's lymphoma or nasopharyngeal carcinoma. Then antibodies to EBNA, that is Epstein-Barr nuclear antigen, which reveals past infection. So this is all about the herpes viruses part 2. There are lesser common herpes viruses like human herpes virus 6, human herpes virus 7, human herpes virus 8. This HHV-8 is also caused the Kaposi's sarcoma. So this is all about the herpes viruses part 2. Thank you for listening.